thank God for the Apostle Paul, because he went, he pushed past all the church folk. He, and before they could lay his body in the ground, before they could write his obituary, the Apostle Paul.
You can have my family. Oh, the devil is already taking up residence in your house. We allow the devil to trounce through our homes as if he owns the place. He's sitting up in the on the couch, got his foot up watching TV, and we just say, oh, go ahead, devil. Just have your way,
big chips. Nah, I got prefers using the small chips. Plus when the score's 90-10, you just got the ball stripped. Plus when the eyes begin.
Praise the Lord and welcome to the inaugural edition of Pastor Nimmons TV. We are so excited that you've decided to tune into this YouTube broadcast. And I'm Pastor Nimmons. God bless you. We've got so many great things in store for you at Pastor Nimmons TV. We're going to give you some great preaching, some great teaching, some exciting interviews. This is a youth-oriented show. We're a lover of everything that's involving youth and young people. We're a lover of gospel, hip-hop, and music. We hope to have some interviews from some gospel hip-hop artists. We want to make you aware of what's going on in that industry on Pastor Nimmons TV. So we've got some great things in store, and I guarantee that you're going to be blessed by what you see at Pastor Nimmons TV. So tell a friend, tell a neighbor, tell a coworker about what's going on Pastor Nimmons TV. Subscribe to this broadcast because you're going to be blessed by what you see at Pastor Nimmons TV. One of the great features of this broadcast is a Bible study that we teach at Wayne State University for the campus ministry of Young Apostolic Students for Christ. This was a campus ministry that was started some years ago back in Michigan State University, and we were blessed to be the president of that chapter while we were in school there. Now we are the teacher of the Wayne State chapter, and during this broadcast and future broadcasts, we're going to be showing you some of the lessons that we are teaching for that campus ministry on Pastor Nimmons TV. In fact, our first inaugural episode, we're going to be dealing with the subject of why apostolic. Why apostolic? What does that term apostolic mean? Where did it come from? What is it all about? Well, you've tuned in at the right time to hear a word from the Lord. So get your Bibles out, get a pad and pen out, because I guarantee that you're going to be blessed by what you see on Pastor Nimmons TV. God bless. Apostle is a title given to the men who followed Jesus as his disciples and were given the charge according to Mark 16 and 15. Let's turn there right quickly. Mark the 16th chapter. Matthew, Mark, Luke. Mark is the second book of the New Testament. Mark, the 16th chapter, verse number 15. And he said to them, go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He who believes and is baptized will be saved. But he who does not believe will be condemned. And these signs will follow those who believe in my name. They will cast out demons. They will speak with new tongues. They will take up serpents. And if they drink any deadly thing, it will by no means hurt them. They will lay hands on the sick, and they will recover. Apostolic is the apostles' doctrine, or the doctrine of the apostles of Jesus Christ. Let's turn to Acts, the second chapter, verses 41 through 42. Then those who gladly received his word were baptized, and that day about 3,000 souls were added to them. And they continued steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine, fellowshipping and the breaking of bread, and in prayers. These two verses talk about the upper room experience that we're going to get into, where the Spirit, the Holy Ghost, was first experienced by the 120 that were in the upper room in Jerusalem. And this is where, in these particular two, in these two verses, we find that the apostolic doctrine is specifically referred to, that these individuals follow in the apostles' doctrine, and they continue steadfastly.
The reason
in the
why
faith.
It is called the apostles' doctrine is because the apostles were the ones that followed Jesus, who were once his disciples. Everybody still with me?
And it makes sense for these individuals to now have graduated from followers to now ambassadors or apostles of Jesus Christ, because they walked with him while he was here. And he says when he left this world, he was not going to leave us comfortless, but he was going to send a comforter. And we're going to get into that in just a minute. But the apostles were given a commission to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. And it makes sense that it's called the apostles' doctrine because these are the individuals that God commissioned directly. And the Bible verifies the element of the apostolic doctrine is salvation according to Acts 2:38. Repentance, baptism in Jesus' name, and the infilling of the Holy Ghost, which evidences itself through speaking with other tongues as the Spirit of God gives utterance. Salvation, people of God, is the fulfillment of the death, burial, and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. In Romans, the 6th chapter, we'll turn there right quickly. And I hope you're writing these scriptures down. Therefore, we were buried with him through baptism into death, that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so, we also should walk in the newness of life. of this process, this salvation process, walks the believer, through Jesus Christ's death, burial, and resurrection. The death is relatable to repentance. We all die. We have to realize and recognize that we are all sinners saved by grace. And in that recognition, we are telling God that he is the only hope that we have for him, for our salvation. Secondly, we are buried with him through baptism, and that is immersion through water. There are some ministries, some religions that sprinkle individuals and throw water and whatnot. You have to be buried just as he was, and then you rise in his resurrection with the Holy Ghost as a new creature. Paul said, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things have become brand new. And if I be lifted up from the earth, I will draw all men unto me. Whenever you are leery about an individual or a particular doctrine or a particular religion, if whatever doctrine you're questioning or whatever doctrine you might have doubts about, if the doctrine is promoting someone other than Jesus Christ, then that should be a clue to you. That is a red flag to you that this is not the truth. If it's promoting anything other than Jesus Christ and him crucified, then it is not the gospel.